Hey guys, on today's episode, we are going to be taking a look at a fantastic redstone contraption that will display and hide armor stands. This is a really, really awesome effect. I want you guys to check it out, so let's jump in. So here we are inside of Minecraft, and obviously this doesn't look very impressive, but the reveal is super impressive. This is obviously a sort of fake version of what your base may look like, and then when you hit this button, wham bam, oh my gosh, armor stands. That is an amazing reveal. I absolutely love it. Obviously these armor stands can be used. I threw a dragon head on one of them. That might be a little bit intense. And once you're finished with it, after you grab the dragon head, it will scoot back into the side of the wall, and the blocks that you had here before will reappear. Right now I have it set to do this with some useful blocks. So this is a crafting table and a loom, obviously, but this could be any type of decoration block. This is using, so let's go ahead and look at some of the redstone back here. This is, I would say, moderately complicated. It is a little bit complicated, but with step-by-step instructions, which you'll get in this video, you'll be able to make this yourself. We are using the honey block that will allow us to move entities. With the slime block, unfortunately, all you could do was like launch entities, but they wouldn't stick to the block. And that is the cool new stuff with the honey block, is that players will stick to it, and of course armor stands will stick to it. That way they can be easily pushed and pulled with this fantastic redstone contraption. Let's get into making it. Over here I have a little bit of a footprint. As you can see, the base, this is kind of in three layers here. The base takes up a sort of small footprint, and then as you get up to the top, it takes up a little bit of a larger footprint. But this is a great little sort of starting position to start with, and I'm using these iron blocks so you can easily count the blocks that you need. This bookshelf right here is representing where my crafting table and loom was. Over here on the side, these are all of the blocks that you'll need to build the redstone, and then over here is some examples of blocks to decorate. You will need some type of either trapdoor or a item frame with a map in it or a painting in order to cover up, and I can kind of show this over here, to cover up the pistons that are needed in order to pull the doorway apart. So you'll need something like that. Obviously you'll need the armor stands. You'll need some type of immovable block that will not be pushed and pulled from the honey. As you can see, the honey is touching this furnace over here. Anything with an inventory will not move, and that includes shulkers and then also glazed terracotta and obsidian. Those type of blocks will not be moved by the honey block. And then any type of decoration block, I'm going to use these bookshelves right here. I like the crafting table because it's kind of practical and it looks like maybe, you know, I like the furnace crafting table combo here because that looks like something you'd actually have in a base without it sticking out too much. Before we get into the step-by-step on the redstone, I do sort of want to explain what's happening with the redstone before we get into the building of it so you can kind of follow along and know if something goes wrong, why it's going wrong. This is the input right here. On the other side, we have the button that will activate this bit of redstone right here. This signal will head this way to this repeater, and then it will split off. One part of the signal goes up to this top layer, and the other part goes through the other side of the block. We'll cover the top part first. All that that does is deal with the timing that comes with this doorway right here and the logs that will move out of the way to push the armor stands forward. So that is the whole top layer, is just to move those logs out of the way and then close them up once that is finished. Where the redstone split off, it's right here. It hits this contraption right here, which is a one tick pulse generator. And so the redstone signal comes in. It's a long redstone signal because it's gone through some repeaters and some buttons and that sort of thing. And when the redstone signal hits this block, it'll power this piston, which will immediately fire off into the air, making that redstone signal very, very short and only one tick long. And then it will pass to the other side, which if a piston gets a one tick pulse, then it will only, and this is a sticky piston here, if that sticky piston gets that one tick pulse, it'll only move the block or pull it back. It won't have enough time to push and then pull back. So it'll move this redstone block from here to over there or over there to back over here. And that is all it does whenever it gets that one tick pulse. Then you have this sort of middle layer. The middle layer is to pull and push the honey blocks that contain the armor stands and just the timing around sending off this double piston contraption. And then the bottom layer here is basically the exact opposite, the timing to send the double piston contraption up to grab the sort of decoration blocks off of the front. So looking at it from this side, I'm going to grab this button and you can see a whole bunch of stuff happens. Doors open, the pistons retract, and then these pistons will push that all back. So we'll just do it from looking at the backside. And you can get a generalized idea of how the redstone works. So now let's go ahead and start building. We're gonna build mostly from the backside, and then this will be the front side. Starting off, you're going to place down four sticky pistons just right on top of each other, and then add a repeater to the back of those sticky pistons. On top of those repeaters, hold down shift and place an observer observing either of those repeaters and then any type of block on top of that. Then we're going to have some redstone just head this way into a comparator. Then just behind and to the right of that comparator will be a repeater on full delay. Then you're going to fill the front and the sides with redstone and send a redstone line all the way to the back here. Next, you're going to add a repeater on full delay and another repeater just on its normal default delay and a redstone torch. Don't worry, the pistons will fire at the front totally fine. Now we're going to add some more redstone and we're just going to sort of snake this direction with it. We're going to add a repeater on full delay, a comparator, and fill the rest, with redstone. And if this contraption right here with the comparator and repeater and this one over here, if they look similar, it's because they are. They are mirrored. Now we are going to start on our middle layer. Go ahead and place a block above that redstone torch, two of them. So one was a temporary block and then the block above it. If you leave that temporary block, you're just gonna have a burnt out torch here because it'll just fire a whole bunch of times. So you're gonna set that second block up, one block above it, and put a torch onto that. It'll fire the other side of this, put some redstone on top of there. Then you're going to put a block on top of that torch and then another one and remove that temporary block with another torch just above it. And then one more piece of redstone on top of that. From that block that we just placed, we are going to come out one, two, three more blocks. And then over here, we're going to come out three more, just like that. So we'll make that sort of contraption. Now we're going to place down some repeaters. The first one is going to be on full delay. The next one is going to be on two extra ticks, three tick delay. Then we're going to add some redstone dust in this configuration. And then place down two repeaters. The first repeater is going to be on full delay. Full delay. And the next one is just going to be on one extra tick. So two ticks delay. Now we're going to come around towards where the front is, looking towards the back, and add our sticky pistons. You're going to have to hold down crouch and you can place them directly onto those repeaters, both of those sticky pistons and two honey blocks, just like this. And this is where your armor stands will eventually end up sitting. Now we are going to build the sort of the input and the signal switcher to switch between the all of the redstone here. So we're going to start off with a redstone block directly on top of that redstone, a temporary block, then a solid block and a sticky piston facing into that bit of redstone. Underneath the block on the back of that piston, place a block and destroy that block. Now we're going to add a repeater, followed by a block on the back of that repeater, a temporary block, another temporary block, destroy the first temporary block, and place a sticky piston facing directly upwards. And now you can destroy that right there. Then a solid block that I swear is not temporary, and add a repeater facing into that. Another block, and another block, and then place a repeater into that as well. Then the redstone signal off the back of this repeater, this line right here, this is your input. And you can kind of snake it anywhere that you want. You can add another repeater if you want the length to be longer. You do need, if we look over here, you do need to make sure that your button isn't directly underneath this trapdoor. Otherwise, when you fire off the button, the trapdoor will fall down because there is a redstone signal that's going to that trapdoor, and so it'll fire off. So you do need to, at a minimum, make sure that it comes out too, and then place your button on your wall, but you can really put this anywhere that you want. For right now, just because this is sort of a demonstration build, we're just going to put a button right there. Now it is time to work on our top layer, and we're going to start to step this up right here and move over. So we're going to add a bit of, where did my redstone go? I don't know where that went. Anyway, here we go. Redstone dust on the top in a line like so. A block on either side of that line with repeaters on full delay. Then we're gonna have to look at the front. Where is the front of our, here we are. Here's the front. So on the left side, you're going to put one block and then another block. And then on the right side, you're going to put two blocks and then a block towards the front. Then we are going to place a diagonal block towards the sky and bring around to the back, put some redstone dust on either side, and then a repeater with two extra ticks, so three ticks total. And then that fires into some redstone torches. These are going to be our pistons that move the door out of the way. And this will be a little bit of a tricky click here, but you're going to click on the face of that redstone torch, and that will place it sort of in midair and immediately fire it, and then place one, a sticky piston below that. So right here and then right there. And those will be your doorway. Now we are at the decoration stage, and if in building all of this, your first little blocks down here got sucked down to the bottom, just go ahead and replace those up near the top. And I'm gonna jump over here and get rid of my inventory and grab some of my decoration blocks. And I'm gonna head over to the other facade that I made and just grab a few more blocks to build with. And so inside of this doorway, you can put anything that matches your base that you enjoy. And then we're just gonna make sure that those logs all face one direction. Over here on the pistons, we're just going to close that up so you don't see that. And then just to show you, you can put down a painting. So if you enjoy the look of a painting, you can do that too. Let me just go ahead and do that on this side as well, because I do like that look. There you go. Two beautiful paintings. Make sure that you add a block that is immovable by honey, which I have mentioned before. And this is all ready to go. I'm gonna move my button to the front here and click it. And then the honey blocks will shoot forward. Now we're gonna put the trapdoors on them. We're just gonna throw those trapdoors right there. If you like the look of the honey, you could keep that, or you can add the trapdoors. Whenever you do this, you do need the armor stand to be on the honey itself. So if it's resting on the trapdoor, when this fires, it's not going to pull off the whole effect correctly. I need to destroy that at some point. So just open up your trapdoors and then place them on the wall back there, and then they'll fall, and then you can close your trapdoors on them and then move on away. Let's see if I can smack. Well, I think There it is. There's the, I was like, how am I going to give him that armor stand? There we go. And so now you can decorate your armor stands however you want with whatever type of armor you have. Super fancy enchanted armor, maybe some dragon heads like me, or maybe some really cool mob skulls. All that is fantastic stuff to throw on your new hidden, not so hidden, super secret armor stands that will pop out of the wall. Big thanks to The Technical Side, that is his YouTube channel, for creating this redstone contraption. You, my friend, are epic. Thank you so, 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 so much. Also, thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a big ol' thumbs up. Make sure you leave a comment down below letting me know your thoughts, and make sure you subscribe for future videos, tips, tricks, tutorials, and spotlights here on OMG Craft. See you next time. Bye!